proper name for this is Crunker Kill You.
Mm-hmm. The Hill of the Keeill.
Yeah, could be, yeah, yeah. Mm. But there's, I'm told there's cobblestones on the floor, and there's white cobbles at the east end, the altar end.
Mm-hmm.
And it was cleaned out about 1910, I think, thereabouts. And that's when this stone was reset here. It had been lying in a hedge further up, and my grandfather said when he was a small boy it was always here, so he had it put back.
Mm-hmm.
So, the graves all run from here. They run in rows up here, and there's a hollow. There's a hollow in the middle here, and the experts tell me the graves were made of stone lintels, mm-hmm. and with using a tractor sometimes atop it, it's caved in. It wasn't designed to take a tractor, you see, so the weight has caved it in. But when you get the grass growing properly, you can see rows of them up here.
Really?
Yeah, there's one row, you can see here, there's a row of graves here. There's another one over there, there's another one over here. And they all run in this direction. You know, it's not a very big Keeill, but none of the Keeills are.
No, they're not. So your father always had a lot of respect for the Keeill as well. Oh yes,
definitely. He wouldn't allow anybody to do anything to it. I mean, he'd be cutting it with the old reaper, and he'd be out with the man on the mower. Those days, the reaper was towed behind the tractor, the horse reaper, and he'd be after the fella because he'd let the blade go in and cut the sod off, and they'd go back and put the sod back. You see, you know, it was no chance of anything happening to it.